hello. So we're in the Halloween journal, and I've got these hands that I've torn from a napkin, and I'm going to stick those down that medium. I would have just had the page, put some tape down the middle, strengthen it. Sorry about that. So, I have this idea of building up a creepy background on this side and doing a creepy face on this side. Oops, a bit orange on there. Don't mind. We'll see how that goes. Thought, you know, it might be nice to get portrait in here, because I do like doing my ladies' faces every now and then. It's good to practice your drawing. Even if you don't think you're any good at it, it's who's to say you're no good at it? It's your style, you know? Your own worst critic. As we know, it doesn't matter that orange is getting in there, it's fine. It's Halloween, it can be mucky and dirty and mucky. Oh, yeah. So, give that a quick blast and then I'll pop some gesso on, I think. So, I'll be back. Just get that stuck down. And when I'll be back. When I'm ready to gesso, probably. So, see you in a mo. Okay, so I think that's dry enough for us to quickly gesso. Mind going in a bit heavy on this side, but then over the skeleton hands will go a bit lighter. And of course, as it dries, the gesso will soften and the background should come through a bit more again. So I'm going to dry that off and what do we do first, colour or stamps? Colour, I think. So we'll be back in a sec with some colour. Okay, so I'm going to go with greens. Got all my green distress inks here. Let's start with the brightest. which is Mowed Lawn. Just gonna put some on here. This is probably gonna move about with layers that we're doing later. This is still wet, but I'm not gonna add any of this over that side of it, like. So glad it's October. I love Halloween. It's really inspired me. I've been in such a creative rut the past few months. I've wanted to create, but no idea what to do, and that just kind of yeah, Halloween, I've got so many ideas. Not enough time to do it all in, unfortunately, but it's life, isn't it? Trying to put some of that down there. Okay. Loving this already. Some peel paint to muddy it down. Not too worried about getting this smooth and beautiful, because as I say, later layers, this is going to move a little bit. It's just a base. Ooh! Leaks, and that before I stand on it. The joys of having a tiny workspace. This peel paint is adding a lovely grungy kind of feel. I love it. It's that murky, swampy kind of feel. Okay. Let's start encroaching on this side a bit. In it as well with that peel paint, or maybe some vintage photo, I'm not sure. Okay. So, just funsies. Ooh, I'm gonna make a mess. Take the lid off your spray and then shake it. Okay. It's going everywhere. It's Lindy, so it should just wash out, I believe. To worry about. No. Okay. So. Love it. And then I'm going to dry that quickly to preserve those splashes. I think I just want to try and get into the centre of it. Just dab a little bit off there where it's a bit dark. Okay, and then dry that up. Okay. Spoiled myself to new stamps. Look at this, it's amazing. do I want to use one of these? I was thinking of the skeleton. But I'm not so sure. Let me just grab out my other ones to look at and see if there's anything else I want to use. And I'll be right back. Okay, yeah. So. It's going to be Mr. Skelly. I feel like I had a skeleton stamp and I can't think where it could be. He's there, but not too in your face, which is what I wanted. And then I think we will go with some cobwebs in the corner. So it's gonna have to go. Maybe I'll just ink up the small one. Yes, I like that. And maybe if I do this. Just getting it on the edge. And then again, or maybe we'll do the big one in the bottom corner. Doesn't matter if it's only partial. Okay, so that is, let's just add some at the top there. Yeah. And now I'm ready to draw my face. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna put it into fast forward, I think, because it might take me some time and I don't want to feel rushed. I want to take my time and get it right because I'm doing it under gesso and colours and it might be difficult to erase anything that I don't like. So I'll be back once we're all drawn out. So I'm just going to do a little bit of light shading with my Derwent Colorsoft pencils. Under there. There we go. Okay. So, colour wise, let's grab a let's just grab this one. So I have Titan Buff. I struggled with that then. Tight buff. And I may need to just get in there. Clean them up so I can get some paint out. Okay. Not the best design for paint tube, I have to say. Let's just make sure I try and squeeze that on properly. Okay. I'm not sure if I'm going to use the flesh tone. Add a bit of water to that, as it obviously dried up a little bit. I'll use this brush. Okay. Now. I want some white paint for her eyes. Again, I'm using the. Sorry, I'm hungry. Sommelier. So. I may have to squeeze a little bit to get the frame. fresh paint. No, I think that's all dried up too, pretty much. It feels like squishy in the tube, but who knows. Right, small brush. Okay, and then we'll grab a little green. Trying to be tidy. Green. Oops. That will tie in nicely with the background. Lovely, and then everyone else hold their breath and paint. We'll do the same again with the black. Actually, there's a little bit in the lid there that I can use. And of course she's going to be gothic beauty, so she's going to have black lips. We will give her some black eyeshadow later. I don't know why I started talking like that. That was weird. before I go down, I'm just gonna draw in her eyebrows. Breathe. Let's do her hair just quickly. There we go, that is painted and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so just finished my dinner and Dracula's on, Bela Lugosi. So let's get back to this. Paint's dried up a little bit. So I get some on the brush. Okay. Give it some highlights. I also need to wash my brushes. Oh dear. So I just want a little blending stump and pencils out. Some Derwent Inktense pencils. And I want black. Top the lid. Sounds like someone's got some fireworks outside. Blend, blend, blend. So I'm going to add a little bit of darkness underneath. Smoky eyes. Okay. to remember that. That works really well for eyeshadow. Okay, so. And maybe we should just add, I've got a pinkish, oh no, I've got my soft ones. Use this one just for a little bit of, little pink in our eyes, make it a bit more real. Into her face. Doing some blending solution really. Great, and now we're going to add some eyelashes. You should see the mess behind me, as always. I've also got my suitcase out and packing to go away on holiday. Well deserved holiday. I think we all deserve a holiday this year, don't we, ladies and gents? Oops. Sort of quilt to match, my lovely lady. I'm really pleased with the way this page has turned out, actually, so far. Up the edges of the lips. I think we could just add a little bit on her hair there. Oh, the focus thing is going, zooming in on her face. I always find that really weird when you draw a face and then the autofocus is like, oh, a face. Brilliant. I want to just add a little something in this corner because there's nothing there. So maybe a spider's web, are we thinking? Yes. Definitely need to wash with brushes. So let's pop that in there. Yeah, let's do that bit again. Try not to dip my stamp in the paint. Brand new stamps, not the gunk and water paint. So, I shall find a quote and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've got some sticker paper, stamp, coloring it in black. Yeah, of course. Exactly a flat surface. Should have used my stamping platform. This is from this Sarah Hurley set. Sorry, upside down. Might stamp him out too. If I have some sort of frame. I think we'll add just a little bit of the peeled paint as well. Got that in archive one as well. So we'll edge it in black. And I'm thinking this fella. We do him on some paper. wish I'd done that on the stamp press. Just so I could get that a little bit darker, but never mind. Let's use the cream in the downward pencil, see. Moving the ink around just a little bit. Ooh. Okay. Just add a little hint of that. Clouds, okay. Bring that book back. I'm thinking that there. Just the title. Got it. Okay, so where did we say we wanted that? There. Just finish it off with black edging. You may have noticed that I've left the napkin hanging on, and I'm going to leave that there. If it comes off, it comes off. Add a raggedy look to our page, to our book. There we go. So shall we date it? Yes. Today is the 4th of the 10th. 2020, there we go. Very nice. I like it. I hope you like it too. I hope you've enjoyed watching, and I'll see you again soon, hopefully. Bye.